Good morning, students. Here we come up with the gross anatomy of mediastinal surface of right lung. So therefore, here we write the topic mediastinal surface of the right lung. Now here, this topic is very important and it is so many times asked in a short note. And here, only one line diagram with various impressions and the points here to mention. Now here this topic can be asked according to write a short note on the relations of mediastinal surface of the right lung or write a short note on the medial surface of the right lung. We know that the medial surface of both right and left lung consists of posterior vertebral impression and anteriorly the major part mediastinal impression. So mediastinal impression of both the lungs is a very important question. Even in the practical classes, when you are asked in Viva, the lung, they will ask you the mediastinal relations of the right and left lungs, which I have discussed with you in my various videos of the dissection of the right and left lung. So you can correlate this with those videos of the dissection where in the Viva, I am discussing with you the mediastinal surface on the right and the left lungs in dissected specimens. So here we go with the mediastinal surface. Now, the relations of mediastinal surface of the right lung, we go according to various points. So the first point here we will write the numbers. The first point will be hilum of the lung. So please write down the hilum of the right lung, along with that pulmonary ligament. This is the first point. So therefore, now on one side, this side, we are going to draw here, we are going to draw the entire surface of the lung. This is what we are going to draw. And therefore, as we draw here, this is the right lung, mediastinal surface of the right lung. Please draw it. Very simple, very interesting. Here, somewhere on this side, we are going to draw the hilum and pulmonary ligament. So this is where we draw the hilum and pulmonary ligament. So therefore, now after highlighting this, we are going to start with the hilum. The hilum of the lung is a triangular non-pleural impression on the mediastinal surface of the lung. It is a triangular non-pleural impression on the mediastinal surface of the lung through which various structures of the root of the lung will enter and exit the lung. So through this hilum, there will be various structures of the root of the lung which will enter and exit the lung. So this triangular non-pleural impression which is present here is known as the hilum of the lung. This hilum is continuous below with that of pulmonary ligament. So here, this is pulmonary ligament. So the hilum is continuous below with pulmonary ligament. And therefore, what is pulmonary ligament? Now the pulmonary ligament is, if I just note it here, pulmonary ligament is bilaminar fold of mediastinal pleura. So it is a, I will write down over here, bilaminar fold of mediastinal pleura. This bilaminar fold of mediastinal pleura will be attaching the lateral border of esophagus with that of the corresponding root of the lungs, corresponding hilum of the lungs. So note down, the bilaminar fold of mediastinal pleura will extend from the right and the left edge of esophagus towards the corresponding right and left hilum of the lung. That is the right hilum or the left hilum. But always note down, this bilaminar fold of mediastinal pleura will extend. It will continue with the hilum. So in short, this hilum will continue below as pulmonary ligament. And this pulmonary ligament is nothing but it is a bilaminar fold of mediastinal pleura. It is attached between the lateral borders of esophagus till the root of the lung. So therefore this forms the pulmonary ligament, bilaminar fold of mediastinal pleura between the lateral margin of esophagus to the root of the lung. So therefore here we are going to mark, please mark here, this will be known as, let me first write down, this structure is known as the hilum, triangular non-pleural impression, which is continuous below with pulmonary ligament. This pulmonary ligament is bilaminar, fold of mediastinal pleura between the lateral margins of esophagus and the medial surface of the lung. So this forms pulmonary ligament. So hilum is continuous below with pulmonary ligament. What do you find in pulmonary ligament? In the pulmonary ligament, you find some loose areolar connective tissue. Also, you will find some lymph vessels. So therefore, this is the pulmonary ligament. Now, structures which are present in hilum, very interesting and very important. The structures which are present in the hilum will be as follows. For the structures, we need more space. So what we can do is, here we can create more space like this. And here, the structures which are present in the hilum, from superior to inferior and from anterior to posterior, please note on, because these structures are asked so many times in MCQs as well as one line question answer. So first we start with that of the bronchus, green color. Structures which are present in the hilum of the right lung root. This is the subtitle here. The structures which are present in the hilum of the right lung root. Sometimes this is an individual question. From superior to inferior, the following are the structures. First structure, please draw here. This is the upper lobe bronchus. Upper lobe bronchus. So therefore, here we are going to write down the upper lobe bronchus. Second structure below that will be the pulmonary artery. So here we are going to draw the pulmonary artery. So this is where we draw pulmonary artery. And remember, for artery we are using blue color because pulmonary artery carries impure blood. And we are going to mention here pulmonary artery. Third structure below the pulmonary artery will be right principal bronchus. So here we go with that of the right principal bronchus. Please draw as I have drawn. Don't draw in a vertical line. This is how the structures are arranged. If you see in the dissection videos of the root of the right lung, exactly the same way these structures are arranged whenever you see in the dissected specimen. So this is the right principal bronchus, that is below the pulmonary artery. And the fourth structure here will be the inferior pulmonary vein. So the fourth structure I am going to draw here, this is the fourth structure and this is inferior pulmonary vein. So therefore I am going to mark this structure as inferior pulmonary vein. So these are the four structures which are present in the hilum of the lung root. Remember, hilum of the lung root, which lung? Right lung root. Superior to inferior, we go with upper lobar bronchus, number one. Number two, pulmonary artery. Number three, right principal bronchus. In some textbooks it is given as hyperarterial bronchus, and upper lobar bronchus is given as eparterial bronchus. So once again, from superior to inferior, upper lobar bronchus, then we go to the second part, that is the pulmonary artery. Then third, right principal bronchus, and fourth, inferior pulmonary vein. Now the same root of the hilum of the right lung, the structures which are arranged from anterior to posterior. Remember here, this is here, if I just mention this lightly, this is anterior, and here this is posterior. So anterior, posterior, the structures which are arranged in the root of the right lung or the hilum of the right lung from anterior to posterior. The first structure will be superior pulmonary vein. So here I am going to draw superior pulmonary vein. And I am going to mark this structure once again here as superior pulmonary vein. So the structures that are arranged from anterior to posterior will be superior pulmonary vein, then pulmonary artery and right principal bronchus. Please note down. Once again, I repeat, the structures which are arranged in the root of the right lung from in the hilum from anterior to posterior will be superior pulmonary vein, pulmonary artery, and the right principal bronchus. These questions from superior to inferior and anterior to posterior are asked so many times in MCQs and 1 mark question answers. Please, you have to buy out these structures, the arrangement of these structures. It's wonderful. Then we come across, we have finished the first point, hilum, the structures which are present in the hilum, and pulmonary ligament. These are the structures which are present in the hilum. First point is over. Now second point. In the second point, we start with cardiac impression. So therefore, this is the cardiac impression, and we have to mark the cardiac impression. So I am going to mark the cardiac impression, and for the cardiac impression, what I will do is violet color, and I will mark this area as cardiac impression. And so here I am going to mark it as cardiac impression. Where is this cardiac impression? It is a small concave area which is present in front of the hilum of the lung, and this much area will be involved in the cardiac impression, where it will carry the impressions of the anterior surface of the right auricle, anterior surface of the right atrium, and anterior surface of right ventricle. Remember, these are the three structures which are related in the cardiac impression here. So, right auricle, right atrium, right ventricle, anterior surfaces, they are related with the cardiac impression which is present anterior to the hilum and the pulmonary ligament. Very simple. Now, third, structure number three. There will be impression for inferior vena cava. So, inferior vena cava impression. And where is this impression for inferior vena cava? There is a vertical groove which will be present in front of pulmonary ligament and behind the cardiac impression. So this vertical groove, I am going to make it over here. This is the vertical groove which is present just in front of here, just in front of the pulmonary ligament, and it is present just behind the cardiac impression. This groove is for the inferior vena cava. So here we have drawn the impression of inferior vena cava, and here we are going to write down inferior vena cava. So this is the groove for inferior vena cava, and exactly the location will be in front of the pulmonary ligament and behind the cardiac impression. Now point number four. There will be another vertical impression that will be for the superior vena cava oblique the right brachiocephalic vein. So therefore, this vertical impression will be just above the cardiac impression, just above the cardiac impression, and that vertical impression will carry in this way. We are going to show this vertical impression. And here we are going to show this as the superior vena cava and the brachiocephalic trunk. So therefore, this is the impression of superior vena cava. Here we are going to write down superior vena cava impression, lower part, and upper part will be the brachiocephalic vein. Impression of brachiocephalic vein. Where is it? Exactly above the pericardium. This will be the lower part will be superior vena cava, upper part will be the brachiocephalic vein impression, both right and left brachiocephalic veins. But right brachiocephalic vein is predominant, right brachiocephalic vein impression. Then we come to point number five. There will be impression above the, there will be a groove like impression which will be above the hilum, and that will be for azygous vein, the impression of azygous vein. So this impression will be in the form of a groove above the hilum of the right lung, and it will open into the superior vena cava. So here we show, in this way we are going to show the azygous vein, the impression of azygous vein. This is how we need to show. So this is the azygous vein, and here we put in the color. This azygous vein is above the hilum, and it is opening into superior vena cava. Before the superior vena cava will pierce the pericardium. So please note down, this will be known as the azygous vein. So impression, that is the groove for azygous vein, will be in the form of an arc above the root of the, or above the hilum of the right lung, and it will open into the, this azygous vein naturally will open into the superior vena cava. So this is impression number 5, impression or groove for azygous vein. Now here we need to make sure, after understanding these three impressions, inferior vena cava, superior vena cava and the azygous vein, we need to introduce one nerve, phrenic nerve, right phrenic nerve. So the right phrenic nerve, always note down, will be located medial to this vein. So I am writing this in the form of dots. So I am drawing this in the form of dots, and then this right phrenic nerve will pass in this direction, and once again it will pass just medial to inferior vena cava. So this is the course of right phrenic nerve. This will be the entire course of the right phrenic nerve. And here we need this as, here we are going to mark it as the right phrenic nerve. And here there is one mark question answer. The right phrenic nerve is accompanied by right pericardiophrenic vessels. So the right phrenic nerve and pericardiophrenic vessels together will travel right to, on the right side to, superior vena cava and brachiocephalic vein. So superior vena cava and right brachiocephalic vein, on their right side will be the right phrenic nerve as well as the pericardiophrenic vessels. That means the right phrenic nerve and pericardiophrenic vessels will always lie between two major structures. Number one, pericardium, and number two, mediastinal surface of the lung, right lung. So between the mediastinal pleura of the right lung and pericardium lies the right phrenic nerve and pericardiophrenic vessels. Therefore, this is one more question answer. Understand this. And another one more question answer is, the right phrenic nerve and pericardiophrenic vessels will always lie on the right side of superior vena cava and right brachiocephalic vein. Should be very clear. Do not complicate. Now this right phrenic nerve will travel in this direction, and then it will pass on the right edge of the inferior vena cava. So this is the course of right phrenic nerve. Now we come to number 6. Now point number 6 in the impressions, very simple, in the point number 6 in the impressions, we come to the impression which is present just behind the brachiocephalic vein. Here there will be a small vertical impression for brachiocephalic trunk. What is brachiocephalic trunk? That is brachiocephalic artery. So there will be another impression here, vertical impression, which will be known as the brachiocephalic trunk impression. So this vertical impression will be just behind and above the impression of superior vena cava and brachiocephalic vein. And this impression will be known as the brachiocephalic trunk impression. So therefore here we are going to write down this as brachiocephalic artery or brachiocephalic trunk. It is brachiocephalic artery or brachiocephalic trunk impression. And before it divides into right side, both the right side common carotid and right subclavian artery. Okay. Then we come to impression number 7. Now this impression number 7 will be the impression which is present just behind the brachiocephalic trunk at the apex of the lung, and that will be just behind the apex of the lung, that will be impression for, vertical impression for trachea. So therefore here there will be a vertical impression for the trachea, which I am going to draw with violet color. So there will be impression of trachea. So this is where the tracheal impression is present, right edge of trachea. Please draw, this is the right edge of the tracheal impression, right edge of trachea. And what will it carry along with it? Along with this trachea, there will be one very important nerve, right vagus nerve. So therefore, along with trachea, there will be this nerve, right vagus nerve. So please note down here, we are going to note down, this is the tracheal depression, right edge of trachea, and the right vagus nerve. The right vagus nerve. And finally, so here, this is the tracheal impression, point number 7. And finally, point number 8, the last impression, please note down here, I am going to make point number 8. I hope you are able to see, no? Okay. So point number 8, the last impression will be O. I start with O. O is silent. Esophageal impression. So therefore, here I am finishing with the esophageal impression, and that esophageal impression will be behind, just behind the hilum. So please draw in this direction. Just behind the hilum, there is one vertical groove impression, and it will be known as esophageal impression behind the hilum. Very simple. And here we are going to write down this as the esophageal impression groove, which is present behind the hilum, and we are going to carry the right vagus nerve, which was along with trachea, into the esophagus in this direction. So therefore, here we complete all the mediastinal impressions of the right lung. How wonderful it is. It is purely diagrammatic. If you remember the diagrams, it is most simple and very interesting to answer. And number one, we start with very interesting. See how we go very fast. Number one, what we have discussed, the hilum of the lung, pulmonary ligament. In the hilum, the structures range from superior to inferior, anterior to posterior. Very simple. Then number two, we have discussed about pericardial impression, cardiac impression. Structure number three, we have discussed about the inferior vena cava impression. Structure number four, we have discussed about the superior vena cava impression, brachiocephalic vein. Structure number 5, the azygous vein impression. Structure number 6, the brachiocephalic trunk impression. Structure number 7, the tracheal impression, along with that the right vagus nerve. And structure number 8, inferior vena cava impression. And always note down the right phrenic nerve and pericardiophrenic vessels, which are lying on the right edge of the brachiocephalic vein as well as superior vena cava. And also the right phrenic nerve and pericardiophrenic vessels will lie between two structures, note down, that is between pericardium and mediastinal pleura. Between pericardium and mediastinal pleura is right phrenic nerve and pericardiophrenic vessels. This is also often asked in MCQs. And the alignment of the structures within the hilum, once again I repeat, it is often asked in MCQs. Superior to inferior, anterior to posterior. So here we finish the entire mediastinal surface, the impressions on the mediastinal surface of the right lung. Thank you very much.